Hi everyone, welcome to Wisdom and Online Classes. So in a rational number lesson, in a previous class, you have learned one of the most very important property, that is a closure property. So once just you recall that property and the definition of the rational numbers. So rational numbers are in the form of P by Q. So here P and Q are called as a integers and Q is not equals to zero. This is the definition for the rational numbers. And you have learned one property with respect to the rational numbers, that is a closure property. So rational numbers will satisfy the closure property with respect to addition, subtraction, multiplication, but it is not satisfied for the division. This is the closure property with respect to rational numbers for all these four fundamental operations. The next one is another one property, that is commutative property. What is this commutative property? What it says for the rational numbers? So what is the commutative property? It says that if you write the those rational numbers in different orders, so if you get the sum as a set, that is a commutative property with respect to addition. If you write those rational numbers in any order, in different order, if you change that in orders, order of the rational number, the sum is remain same. So I will just give one example here. For example, A and B are called as a rational numbers. Here A is a rational number and B is a rational number. If you change B's order, order is nothing but it is A plus B, it is a one order. A plus B is a one order. If you change the order as B plus A, if the sum is same, if the sum is same is nothing but this A plus B is equals to the B plus A. So I change the order here, A plus B. Another one order I change it as B plus A is also here. If after changing this rational number order, again if you get the sum as a same, this is called as a commutative property with respect to addition. Okay? So the first one is this commutative property with respect to addition. I have taken here two rational numbers. The one is 2 by 3 and another one is 7 by 8. So what is commutative property says that if you write those rational numbers in any order, the order is like A plus B and B plus A. If the sum is remain same, that is a commutative property with respect to addition. So here the A value is 2 by 3 and here the B is 7 by 8. So these two are called as a rational number. First, write in order A plus B. So write those two rational numbers in the order of A plus B. So 2 by 3 plus 7 by 8. Okay. So these are all are, as you know that these two are like and like. So take the LCM. Right. So LCM is 24. The next 8 to 16 and 7 is 21. What is the sum is 37 divided by 24. So the order of A plus B, so what is the sum is 37 divided by 24. So next you change this order. Order is nothing but A plus B. You have done already this sum for A plus B. Change that order as B plus A here. So what is the value of B? 7 by 8. The value of the A is 2 by 3. The find the answer, find the sum for these two rational numbers. After finding the sum for these two rational numbers, what is the sum is 37 divided by 24. So what you can observe here, observe those two order. This is order of A plus B. This is order of B plus A. After changing these two orders, so can you find out the any differences in the sum? So here the sum is 37 divided by 24. Here the sum is 37 divided by 24. So what we can conclude that? So the conclusion is A plus B is equals to the B plus A. Are you getting my point? So we can tell that it is satisfied for the, it is is the commutative property. This commutative property is satisfied for addition of the rational numbers. Okay, after changing of this order, again the sum is remains same. Okay, what is the commutative property? Says with respect to the rational numbers, so if you change that order, if you get the sum as a remains same, that is called as a commutative property respect to addition for the rational numbers. So now we can conclude this: a plus b is equals to the b plus a. The sum is 37 divided by 24 is equals to 37 divided by 24 for the a plus b is equals to the b plus a. Okay, this is commutative property with respect to addition. The next one is the commutative property with respect to the subtraction. The next, move on with the commutative property with respect to subtraction. The next one is, this is the commutative property for subtractions. So what is the commutative property? Says for the addition. So if you change the order, if you get the sum remains same, a plus b is equals to b plus a, that is called as a commutative property for addition. So if you change the order also here, so a minus b equals to b minus a, is it possible? This is our question, right? So here the same a and b are called as a, the rational numbers. So I have taken the a value as 2 by 3 and b value as 7 by 8 here. So just you have to find it here, a minus b, is it equals to the b minus a? This is our question. So you can find the answer here, the a minus b. So how you can find? The a value is 2 by 3 minus the b value as 7 by 8. Okay. So what is the LCM is? As you know that 24 is LCM. So 8 to the 60 and 3 into 7, that is a 21. So 16 minus 21, 16 minus 21, yes exactly, that is minus 5. So minus 5 divided by 24, because you are subtracting the bigger number from the smaller number. So that's why the answer is minus 5 divided by 24. So they change the order. This is a minus b. The next you change this order as b minus a. So b minus a is here. So b is 7 by 8. A is 2 by 3. So what is the answer is 21 minus 16 divided by 24. So 21 minus 16. What is the 21 minus 16? That is 5. Plus 5 divided by 24. So what did you observe this? So here a minus b value is minus 5 by 24, b minus a value is 5 by 24. What we can finally conclude this? Are they equal? Their differences, are they equal? See, a minus b value is minus 5 by 24, b minus a value is 5 by 24. Are they equal? No, exactly here 5 by 24, it is not equals to the minus 5 by 24. So this is 5 by 24. This is minus 5 by 24. What you can say that? So are they equal? After changing this order, as a minus b is equals to b minus a, can you tell this order is same? So here it is not equal. What we can finally tell that? A minus b, it is not equals to the b minus a. You can go with the sum of the example and you will get the final clarification. So the adder is the 5 by 24. It is not equals to the minus 5 by 24. What we can tell that finally? So here we can tell that the commutative property for the subtraction, it is not satisfied for the rational numbers. Okay, so it is not satisfied for the rational numbers. Finally, we can tell that these two, the difference between these a minus b, it is not equals to the b minus a. This is the final conclusion for this commutative property for subtraction for the rational numbers. Finally, the commutative property, it is not satisfied for the multiplication. So here what is the order is A into B equals to B into A. Are they equal? This is our the condition, right? So you have to check it whether these two are equal. The product of A into B is equals to the product of B into A. You have to check here the value. I have taken the two rational numbers again as A and B here. These two are rational numbers here. A is 2 by 3 and B is 7 minus 7 by 8. Here A into B. The first order is A into B. So just 2 by 3 into minus 7 by 8. Okay. So multiply. So as you know that multiplication of the rational number. So multiply the numerator with the numerator and multiply the denominator by the denominator here. So minus 7 into 2 minus 14 and 8 into 3 is 24. The next one is the answer for A into B. The product of A into B is minus 14 divided by 24. The next one is the change the order. This order has A into B. The next change this order as B into A. Minus 7 by 8 into 2 by 3. Okay. So minus 7 into 2 is minus 14 and 8 into 3 is 24. What is the answer? What is the product of B into A? The product for B into A is minus 14 divided by 24. Are they equal? So this product, is it equals to this? After changing the order as A into B, I change the order as B into A. Are they equal? Yes. See here, this minus 14 by 24, it is equals to the minus 14 by 24. We can finally conclude that what we can conclude, this A into B is equals to B into A. What we can tell that finally the commutative property with respect to multiplication, it is satisfied for the rational numbers. The rational numbers is satisfied the commutative property with respect to the multiplication. What we can finally tell that this minus 14 by 24, it is equals to this minus 14 by 24. So the finally is this, the product A into B, the order is equals to the B into A. This is the commutative property for the rational number. A and B are called as the rational numbers here. A is a rational number, B is a rational number. So here A into B is equals to the B into A. This is commutative property for multiplication for the rational numbers. The next one is check it for the division. So the next one is the commutative property with respect to division. So here the condition is A divided by B, is it equals to the B by A. So what we can do here, the change the order as A by B, the change it as B by A here. So the A value is 2 by 3 and B value is 7 by 8 here. A and B are called as the rational numbers, right? So here A divided by B, so 2 by 3 by the 7 by 8 here. So this is the take the reciprocal 2 by 3, 7 by 8, take the reciprocal of this 7 by 8 as 8 by 7. So 8 into 2 is 16 and 7 into 3 is 21. So what is the value of A divided by B? The value of A by B is 16 divided by 21. So next one is I will change this order as B divided by A. The value of B is 7 by 8 and the value of A is 2 by 3. What is the reciprocal of 2 by 3? That is 3 divided by 2. So 7 into 8, 7 divided by 8 into 3 by 2. So that is 7 into 3 is 21 and 8 into 2 is 16. The value of B divided by A, what is the value of this? 21 divided by 16. Finally, what you can conclude this? This A divided by value is 16 divided by 21 and the order, I change this order A by B as B by A. So this is the answer is 21 divided by 16. Are they equal here? So they are not equals to each other. This A divided by B, it is not equal. equals to the b divided by a. Because see here, 16 divided by 21, it is 16 divided by 21, it is not equals to the 21 divided by 16. So a divided by b is not equals to b divided by a. So what is our final conclusion is the commutative property for division with respect to rational numbers is not satisfied. So rational numbers are not satisfied for the commutative property with respect to the division. Okay. So finally, the ones just you recall what you learned. The ones again. The commutative property with respect to addition, it is satisfied. And commutative property with respect to subtraction, it is not satisfied. And commutative property with respect to multiplication, it is satisfied. A into B is equals to the B into A. And finally, commutative property with respect to division, it is not satisfied. A divided by B not equals to the B divided by A. This is the commutative property for the rational numbers. The next class, you will learn the another one property, that is associative property for the rational numbers. Thank you.